Hello everyone, welcome to Topper Learning. Today in this webinar we will understand CBSE 12th commerce syllabus and the changes made in it by CBSE. So firstly, let's understand the flow of the webinar. Students, in this webinar we will be covering or talking about syllabus for CBSE class 12th commerce, changes made in the syllabus, board exam marking scheme and paper pattern. And lastly, we will talk about doubts and solutions platform. So let's start with the first thing, which is commerce. So this webinar is on commerce and we need to understand what are the main subjects in CBSE class 12th commerce. So students, we know that there are three main subjects. The first one is accountancy, then we have business studies and economics. So these are the three main subjects in commerce. Now let's firstly talk about accountancy. So let's see the core structure of accountancy. So this year, students, you can see in accounts you have three parts: Part A, Part B and Part C. Part A is your compulsory part, which is on accounting for not-for-profit organizations, partnership firms and companies. Under Part A, you have three units. The first unit is on financial statements of not-for-profit organizations, which is of 10 marks. Then we have accounting for partnership firms, which is of 35 marks. Then accounting for companies, which is of 15 marks. So in total, your Part A is of 60 marks. Coming to Part B, students, we have financial statement analysis. Under this, we have two units. And the first unit is on analysis of financial statements, which is of 12 marks. And the next one we have is cash flow statement, which is of 8 marks. So your Part B is of 20 marks. Besides this, students, you also have project work, which is of 20 marks. And this 20 marks divided into project file, written test and Viva. And you can see that file is of 4 marks, your written test is of 12 marks and Viva is of 4 marks. So just making the file will not fetch you marks in project. If you really want to score well in project, you need to understand what you are making. Now students, Part A is your compulsory part. But in Part B, you can either choose financial statement analysis or computerized accounting. And under Part C, you have practical work. So this is about the core structure of accountancy. Now let's talk about business studies. Now students, similarly in business studies also, we have three parts. You have two books. All of you must be aware that you have two books in business studies. The first part is on principles and functions of management. The second part is on business finance and marketing. And the third one is your project work. So you can see that only one project file needs to be prepared by you. So your Part A, students, is of 50 marks. Part B is of 30 marks. Then you have your project work, which is of 20 marks. So in total, 100 marks for business studies. So this is about the business studies course structure. Now let's come to economics. In economics, we have two parts, microeconomics and macro, plus we also have the project work. So theoretically, you have two books, micro and macro. Micro is of 40 and macro is of 40. So both the books are of 40 marks each. And your Part C is your project work, which is of 20 marks. So we can see that in all the subjects, in all the main commerce subjects, accountancy, economics, and business studies, we have project work. Okay, so just learning the theory is not what the CBSE is focusing upon. CBSE is giving equal weightage to learning and understanding the things and making a project a practical file on it. Now, students, let's understand the changes made in the syllabus, and we will be starting with accountancy. So we are comparing this year's syllabus with the last year, and we are analyzing what are the changes that have been made in the syllabus. So let's talk about accountancy. So if we just see the accountancy syllabus, we can jot down these points. The first one, a new chapter known as Accounting for Not-for-Profit Organization has been added for 10 marks. So this year you will be learning new chapter, a chapter on accounting for not-for-profit organizations. And the weightage for accounting for companies has been reduced from 25 to 15 marks. So this has been a change this year. Also, the topic redemption of debentures by conversion and purchase in the open market has been deleted from accounting for companies. So you need not to prepare this topic, because this topic has been deleted from the syllabus. And also, one good news for the students who don't like value-based questions. So this year, you won't be getting any value-based question in the paper, because these questions have been deleted from the syllabus. So this is about accountancy, students. Now let's come to business studies. Now, good thing that a topic, demonetization, the concept of demonetization and features, this topic has been added to Unit 3. So in the chapter Business Environment, besides learning about business environment, the impact of business environment on business, you will also learn demonetization, which is good, because demonetization is a very important concept, and you need to know how it has affected the economy, what is the concept, what are the features of it. So this year you will be learning about demonetization, and you can also expect questions from this topic. Now, merits and demerits of formal and informal communication have been deleted from Unit 7 Directing. So in chapter Directing, you need not to learn about the merits and demerits of formal and informal communication. You just need to know the meaning of it. Only merits and demerits have been deleted. The major thing is that earlier there were two projects to be done by the students, but now only one project is to be done by the students. So this is a relief to the students, because now you need to make only one file instead of two files. And estimated time for questions has also been changed. A topic induction training of Unit 6 staffing has been deleted from the heading topics, but retained under the heading learning outcomes. So this means that you should know what is induction training. And in business studies also, value-based questions have been deleted. So this is about business studies, students. So we have seen there are some changes in accountancy and business studies. But if we talk about economics, students, no change for this session of 2018 and 19. So this year you won't find any change in economics syllabus, but for session 2019 and 20, Indian Economic Development of class 11th will replace the introductory microeconomics for class 12th. So your micro will be shifted to class 11th, and Indian Economic Development will be the part of your class 12th syllabus. So in economics, there are no changes. In accountancy and business studies, there are changes, and we have discussed all the changes. Now, students, let's understand the question paper design. This is very important, and we will talk about this subject-wise. So starting with accountancy, this is very important, because if you don't know your question paper design, you won't know how to score full marks. In order to score full marks in the subject, you should know how your paper will look like. So in the paper, students, in accountancy paper, you will get 1 marker, 3 marker, 4 marker, 6 marker, 8 marker questions. Okay, so there will be no 2 marker, 5 marker. and the questions will be of remembering, understanding, application, HOTS, and evaluation type. And you can see the weightage, 20% weightage to remembering, 30% to understanding, 25% to application, 20% to HOTS, and 5% to evaluation. Okay, so this is the weightage, and you can also see how the questions have been divided. So 3 questions of 1 mark, 2 questions of 1 mark from understanding, 2 questions of 1 mark from HOTS, and 1 question of evaluation category of 1 mark. So this is the category. So in the examination, you will be getting 8 questions of 1 mark, 4 questions of 3 marks, 5 questions of 4 marks, 4 questions of 6 marks, and 2 questions of 8 marks. So in total, you will be getting 23 questions in the paper. Okay, and the paper will be of 80 marks, 20 allotted to your project work. So 100 marks in total, and all the questions carrying 8 marks will have an internal choice. So this is the good thing, that you will be having internal choice for 8 marker questions. Now, this is about accountancy students. Now, let's talk about business studies. In business studies, you will be getting 1 marker, 3 marker, 4 marker, 5 marker, and 6 marker questions. And these are also categorized as remembering, understanding, application, HOTS, and evaluation. So there will be 8 questions of 1 mark, 5 questions of 3 marks, 6 questions of 4 marks, 3 questions of 5 marks, 3 questions of 6 marks. In total, there will be 25 questions in the paper. The paper will be of 80 marks, 20 marks for your project work. And you can see that you need to understand. You need to understand the concepts. You need to know how to apply the knowledge into various situations, because you can see the weightage. More weightage has been assigned to understanding, application, HOTS. Okay, so just remembering the concepts will not fetch you good marks. This is about business studies, students. Now let's move to economics. Now in economics, you will be getting 1 marker, 3 marker, 4 marker, and 6 marker questions. And the same category, remembering, understanding, application, HOTS, and evaluation. But of course, the percentage is different for each of the subjects. Remembering is of 27%, understanding 24%, application 19%, HOTS 17%, and evaluation 13%. Now, if we see the number of questions marking wise, so you will be getting 8 questions of 1 mark, 4 questions of 3 marks, 6 questions of 4 marks, and 6 questions of 6 marks. So students, in the exam, there will be 24 questions in total, and the paper will be of 80 marks, 20 marks allotted to your project work. And the good thing, that there will be internal choice in questions of 3 marks, 4 marks, and 6 marks in both the sections A and B. So total 3 internal choices in section A and total 3 internal choices in section B. So this is about the question paper design, students. Now we will understand how Topper Learning can help you prepare for your exams the right way. Now students, if you just log in into topperlearning.com, what you need to do? You need to select your class and just click the option class 1 to 12. Then you will get the board option. You need to select the option, like whatever option you are having. So if we are talking about class 12th commerce, CBSE, so you will select CBSE and you will select 12th commerce. After this, students, you will find this page wherein you will get all the commerce subjects, accounts, PST, economics, and mathematics. Then you can choose the subject which you want to study. After choosing that, you will get the option. Let's suppose you have chosen economics. After choosing economics, you will get the options of chapters, practice, topper classroom, and textbook solutions. So in chapters, you will find revision notes. In practice, you will find test. In topper classroom, you will find the videos, concept-wise videos. So if you're weak in any particular topic and you need to understand that topic, just view the video and everything will be clear. And textbook solutions, so you will get the NCERT solutions. We know that CBSE always focuses on NCERT. So you cannot miss any of the questions which are there in your NCERT textbook. So if we talk about the commerce resources, so when you log in into topperlearning.com, students, you will find sample papers, previous year papers, concept video lessons, and test. Now, this is not the end, because you will be getting one more thing, which is doubts and solutions. So students, on Topper Learning website, you will find this platform, which is doubts and solutions. So on the website, you just need to click doubts and solutions. After clicking it, you need to select the board. So for class 12th commerce CBSE, you will select the board CBSE and you will choose CBSE 12th commerce. After choosing this, you can find all the questions. So all the questions which have been or which are asked by the students, you will find all the questions along with the answer. And if you have asked the question, the unanswered question will be there. In my questions, you will find the questions which you have asked and you will find the answers. Okay, so this is the platform wherein in case you are in middle of something, you want to ask something. Okay, some concept is not clear, you have a doubt, then just go to Doubts and Solutions platform, ask your doubt, and you will get the answer within 24 hours. So that's a good part. With Doubts and Solutions, all your doubts will be resolved. Okay, students? So that's all for today. I hope you are now familiar with the changes in the syllabus. Thank you.